Hello again, everyone. Welcome to a new Let's Play of a game from my childhood. Once again, it is a Sierra adventure game. Let's get started. Please center your joystick. I'm not using one. You can't make me, game. You can't make me. Press escape if you do not wish to use a joystick. Okay, I'll do that. Ha! The Black Cauldron. Copyright 1987 by the Walt Disney Company and 1986 and 1987 by Sierra Online. The Black Cauldron is, as it says there, primarily designed and programmed by Al Lowe, who most people will recognize more from, the Leisure Suit Larry games. Listen to that lovely, lovely PC speaker emulation. So, the Black Cauldron, was one of Disney's movies. It was, one of their animated movies. It was basically their attempt to try to branch out from just fairy tales. So they licensed the property, the Black Cauldron, from Lloyd Alexander, who wrote the Chronicles of Brydon, of which the Black Cauldron is the title of the second book. And they basically merged elements from the first two books and dramatically changed them. And the movie was not successful at all. Hey, Goose. Hey, Goose. Don't you honk at me. I will eat you. Anyway, it really was not successful, and it is actually, I think, probably one of the only Disney animated movies, at least before the 2000s, that I have not seen. Even when they regularly went, would release their movies on VHS and then DVD, The Black Cauldron almost always was ignored. It did get a DVD release, but it was a fairly limited run, I think. I'm not sure that it's easy to get on DVD right now. I haven't looked. I mean, since I've got a Blu-ray player and everything, I would wait until Blu-ray is out, but I'm not holding my breath. Anyway, the game itself, since it's based on a Disney movie, is geared at a bit of a younger audience than, say, King's Quest, Space Quest, that sort of thing. So they actually did away with the text parser. You have the function keys. You can choose a new object from your inventory, use that object from your inventory, and the all-purpose do command. And then, of course, look. The all-purpose do command allows you to open doors, which you'll see in a moment, pick up items, talk to people, basically anything that you can actually do in a Sierra adventure game, this is what you use the command for, with the exception of using items from your inventory. Let's go ahead and put it up at the fast speed. So, this game was essentially the middle, aimed at a slightly older audience than Mixed Up Mother Goose, but not quite, but as I said, not quite as old an audience as the King's Quest game. So that's why they got rid of the text parser. Anyway, let's go ahead and open the door and go inside. Hey there, sir, old guy sitting behind the table. Let's talk to you.
Taran, it's time for you to feed our favorite pig, Henwen, says old Dalbin. Take good care of her. She is a very special animal.
Oh, you don't say. I'm sure we'll find out more about that eventually. You open the cupboard. This knapsack will hold just about anything you may find. Actually, I should be looking at these items, too. Care Dalbin is noted for its delicious apples. You love their sweet, crisp taste. You take the apple. It certainly looks delicious. You notice some freshly baked bread. That smells delicious. This looks like enough bread for three meals. Hint, hint. I think it means you can use it three times. Ha ha. An empty water flask is here. The water flask is made of soft leather. It appears that Dalbin's cupboard is bare. The cupboard is bare, so you close it. You carefully reach over the pot, the fire, and take Henwin's pot of simmering gruel. Care Dalbin warms your heart as the glow of this fire warms your body. Ouch! Don't stick your hand in the fire! So yes, basically you do almost everything with just those commands. Hey, Goose. Goose, come here. Come here. Come here. Don't you honk at me. I will eat you. Hey, goat. Ow, the goat thinks you want to play tag. And then it knocks you down. This shed is attached to Dalbin's cottage. You open the door of the shed, discover some dried corn. You reach into the shed and pick up the corn. And the goat knocks me down again. I will get you, goat. You will make a delicious meal one day. Anyway, before we do anything else, let's go get some other items. And wander around a bit. This bridge marks the boundary of Caer Dalbin. You wonder what the future holds. I think this was probably my first exposure to Pride and the Pride and Chronicles and any of Lloyd Alexander's work. But then I went out and actually read the books and discovered they were so much better than the game. Your feet are wet from walking through the shallow stream. And look, you can walk on water! Taran is Jesus. There's a wallet beneath the bridge. Reaching under the footbridge, you take the wallet and look inside. It is filled with food! So is food currency here? I don't know. The wallet is actually from the books. Let's go ahead and take a look at our inventory. We can, up in the action menu, see object. Let's look at the knapsack. This knapsack has been a favorite of yours for years. This pot of gruel makes a tasty dish, if you're a pig. You have some bread baked at Caer Dalbin. Bread. Dalbin delicious apples are your favorite, crisp and tasty. Lies, lies! They're not green. That's not a green apple. Only green apples are good apples. The only good apples are green apples, I should say. Henwin just loves dried corn like this. This food wallet must be magic, since it never seems to run out of food. Ooh. What kind of food fits in a wallet, anyway? Water flask. This is your trusty water flask. That reminds me. I should go fill that up. Yes, this game actually does have hunger and thirst. I don't know why. It's kind of cruel. All right, let's go ahead and fill the flask with water. Woohoo! I think I actually want to go this way first. Get stuck on roots. All is good. Back to Caer Dalbin's house. Stop honking at me. I will eat you. You will be tasty and delicious. Oh look, a conspicuous looking hole. You discover a musical lute inside a hole in this tree. You could always take the lute and run. Oh, the puns. Well, I guess we might as well loot the tree. You take the lute and realize that it is slightly out of tune. Well, let's fix that. Ah, more PC speaker. After a brief tuning, the lute sounds better. Ah, Taran has hidden talents. Although the music doesn't seem, the PC speaker doesn't seem to be emulated very well right now for some reason. It sounded better earlier. For an assistant pig keeper, you make beautiful music. Incidentally, that assistant pig keeper title that he has, that is from the books, but it's given to him by a character who isn't in the game. Because, of course, you kind of have to have an assistant, there has to be a regular pig keeper to have an assistant pig keeper, and this game has no pig keeper, other than Taran, so it doesn't make sense. Doesn't I tell you? Uh-oh, no, no! I forgot about the goat. No! Stop it! He's stunlocking me! Get out of here! Ugh, stupid goat. I will get you, goat. I will. I will eat you and you will be tasty. Let's go this way. Your throat is dry. Dang it. Oops. That turns off the sound. So now we have an item called water. Let's go ahead and drink that. The water from your flask tastes delicious. Again, lies. There's no ice in it. Ignoring plot. So good. So good. The swamp to the west is impenetrable. The land is unstable and soggy. It's not totally impenetrable. We're at the northeast corner of Morva Marsh. It's a dismal, gloomy swamp with dangerous bogs. Good for it. Good for it. The swamp to the southwest seems impossible to cross. The land is unstable and soggy. The trees here are old, gnarled, and bewildering. Alright, well, let's not go up that way quite yet. These trees look quite interesting. Let's walk through the mouth of that one. Oh, hey! Someone ruined a perfectly good piece of paper with a dagger. How rude. You look at the tree and see a dagger holding up a no trespassing sign. You carefully remove the sharp dagger from the tree. The no trespassing sign is lying at the base of the tree. You have no use for a no trespassing sign, so you leave it here. Oh, come on, Taran, that's just littering. You should at least take it back and recycle it. Oh, look, automatic swimming. We didn't have to do anything. Well, let's go swimming. Uh-oh. Oh, no. Oh, no, as the turbulent water pulls you under, your last thoughts are of your beautiful home, Cair Dalbin. Oh, darn. We died. Well, thank you all for watching, Let's Play Black Cauldron. That's it. Game is over. No more. I'm sure some of you would... Yeah, what is up with the sound? I think I might have to restart my DOS box. Sorry, Taran, you have failed in your quest. The Horned King now has the Black Cauldron, and evil rules Prydon. Yes, we are totally telling you these things that you have not learned about yet. Oh well, that's the way it goes. Let's go ahead and restore it. I'll restart the emulator after the end of the episode. Let's go ahead and head back to Cair Dalbin. Might as well do some stuff there. All right, Henwin, I'm apparently supposed to feed you. What do you want, gruel or corn? There's nothing to do here. What are you talking about? You open the gate and notice it has fallen off its hinges. You'll have to fix it someday when you have time. That is not now. I do not have time now. I guess we'll give Henwin some gruel. You feed the gruel to your hungry pig, Henwin. Henwin certainly enjoys eating. Who doesn't? Food. Oh, Henwin is trotting away. Perhaps she's going to Dalbin's cottage. Perhaps she is. Well, let's go ahead and follow her. You open the door. Hey there, Dalbin, what's going on? You can't do anything here. Look, something's wrong with Henwin. I think that's supposed to be Taran saying that. As Henwin places her snout in the water, she enters a trance. A vision appears above the bowl. That's not how it happened in the book. Whee! Let's just zoom in on some guy's face. Some very ugly guy's face. Wearing a cloak. Yes, just zooming in. Whee! Constant zooming.
Taran, says Dalbin. You've never known about Henwin's magic powers, but unfortunately the time has come for me to tell you. Henwin can show us things that happen in faraway places. Through her vision, she is now telling me a terrible tale.
How can you get that from just zooming in on some guy's face?
The Horned King, the most evil ruler in all Prydon, is searching for Henwin. He could force her to use her visions to reveal the location of the Great Black Cauldron. If he finds the Black Cauldron, he will have unspeakable power. Taran, you must take Henwin to the hidden cottage of the Fairfolk. They are our only hope to keep her from the Horned King. Good luck, Taran. Take this coil of rope and hurry. I'm sure you'll need it along the way. Before the Horned King's power becomes unstoppable.
So are you going to tell me where I need to go? You're not, are you? You're just going to leave it to me to figure it out. How rude. I mean, if it's a hidden cottage, maybe you should tell me where it is. Just saying. Ugh. Anyway, I have 5 points now. Yay! I guess we'll pick it up in the next episode as we try to find this hidden cottage. And by try, I mean find it, because I know exactly where it is. Anyway, we'll see you next time.